Hello everyone and welcome to another tutorial with the See QuickBooks training. Today I'm going to show you how to do progress invoicing in QuickBooks Online. So let's get started. The first thing that we want to do is turn on progress invoicing in QuickBooks. So we go to the gear icon, then account and settings. And under the sales tab, we will see progress invoicing. We want to turn that on by clicking on the box and clicking save. Now we can go ahead and do progress invoicing. I'm going to go to a sample customer file and create an estimate. I'm going to do cool cars. And then under the customer file, I'm going to click new transaction estimate. What I want to do is create an estimate using the sample items so we can invoice it and do a progress invoicing. Okay, so let's do concrete, and I'm going to do 1,000, and I'm going to do installation of landscape 1,000. And I'm going to select 1/3 one rock fountain, and that is $275. So as you can see, the total estimate amount is $2,275, and these are not taxable, so we want to uncheck this. Once the customer approves the estimate, we can create an invoice. Then QuickBooks wants to know how we want to bill it. Do we want to do the total estimate? Do we want to do a certain percentage, or do we want to do different amounts for each line item? I'm going to do the percentage, and I'm going to do 20% of each line. So I'm going to create invoice. And as you can see, QuickBooks automatically calculates what's 20% of the total amount of the line item in the estimate. So 20% of 1,000 is 200. And as we can see here, and then 20% of 275 is 55. So QuickBooks has done the calculation for us. And as you can see here, the invoice that is owed, or the amount that is owed to us, is 455. And as you can see here, QuickBooks links the invoice with the estimate that we've done. Each line item is linked to that estimate. So when we save, as you can notice, it doesn't say how much we billed on the estimate, but once we click save, I want to show you the difference. Once we click on the link, it will tell us that we've invoiced 200 and what the remaining is for that line item. So that's what I wanted to show you. I wanted to show you how you can do progress invoicing in QuickBooks Online. I hope that you find this helpful. If you like this video, please give thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I will see you on the next one.